Father, as I thanks and praise in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Almighty God, you want to search the world. Speak to us that we will understand in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I want everything this morning. We want to see in a new way. Father, also Lord, in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Today, we are looking at the thing in the name of Jesus Christ. As we all know that today is this Sunday after Trinity. And the subject for today is the unity of Christ, one. And our topic for this morning is conception. And our text is taken from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 35, and Luke chapter 1, verses 36 to 35. Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 35, I will read. This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. His mother Mary was willing to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man, I did not want to expose her to the public disgrace. He had his mind to divorce her quietly. But after he has considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you have to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sin. All this took place to reveal what the Lord had said through the prophets. The virgin will be with child, will give birth to a son, and we will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. When Joseph spoke up, he did what the angels of the Lord had commanded. He took him and took Mary home as his wife, but had no union with her until she gave back to his son and gave him the name Jesus. This is the word of the Lord. The aim of our study this morning, one, to discover some prophecies concerning the Christ's unique conception that are different from natural conception. Two, to learn from the charity of Virgin Mary. And three, to teach the importance of charity to the Christian family. Introduction. Inviting is someone who has ever engaged in sexual intercourse. The conception of Jesus Christ describes how the Savior was conceived in the womb of the young Virgin Mary through the miraculous work of the Holy Spirit and without Mary having sexual intercourse with any man. God used this mystery, which is beyond human understanding, to bring the Son into the world, as we have in Bible passages here, Matthew chapter 1, verse 18, and Luke chapter 1, verses 34 to 35. I believe that we are all familiar with that story, the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ, how angel appeared to Mary, and how Jesus Christ came to this world without sexual intercourse. In the human history, Jesus Christ was the only person that was born without having sexual intercourse, because Jesus Christ is divine being. I pray as we further this study, the Lord will open our eyes to see him more clearly in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's go to our question guide this morning. Question number one. What are some biblical evidence of Virgin's conception of Christ? Jesus, as we have in Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14.
Looking at the text, Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14. Therefore the Lord himself shall give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel. If we look at the text, friend, we'll see that the birth of Jesus was meant to come by as a mystery, which is going to be held over understanding. And what the prophecy has been said, whatever God says he will do, that's what he's going to do. So we can see this as an evidence in the scripture that Jesus was meant to come through a virgin, and this is exactly what happened.
Thank you. Question number two. You mentioned between natural human conception and divine conception of Jesus Christ, as we have in the following Bible references here, Genesis chapter 4, verse 1, and verse 17 of the same chapter, verse 25 and 16 of the same chapter, and also Matthew chapter 1, where we read other time, and Luke chapter 1, where we read other time.
Genesis 4, 1, and Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. This was it from the beginning. To bring forth a child will require the husband and the wife having sexual intercourse, and that has remained till forever. But we notice from the passages read to us in Matthew and Luke that the birth of Jesus was not like this. The Bible says that in sin, my mother conceived me, in sin I was born. Anyone who comes by that natural conception will be born a sinner. And God, wanting to bring a redeemer from sin, needed to bring him as a pure seed. And that was why it was the Holy Spirit of God that overwhelmed Mary, and Mary as a virgin then conceived and gave birth to Jesus. So the conception of Jesus was pure without the trace of sin.
What does the Bible teach about charity of men and virgins? Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 20 to 29, Acts 15, verse 20 to 21, and 21 to 25, and 1 Corinthians 6, 18, 1 Thessalonians 4, 3.
1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 2. Nevertheless, to avoid fornication, let every man have his own wife, and let every woman have her own husband. In other words, Bible frowned at unchastity. Bible did not allow anything that has to do with immorality. And so therefore, Bible teaches us that we should abstain from any immorality. The church cannot be perfect unless it gets to the level of cleanliness. It get to the level of holiness. So therefore, the Bible rule out anything that has to do with fornication, rule out anything that has to do with adultery, and so therefore he allows man and woman to get married.
Thank you, question number four. What lesson can Christians draw from Mary's state of visit of angel? Isaiah chapter 1, verse 16. 2 Timothy 2, 20-21, and James 4, 8.
Isaiah chapter 1, verse 16 says, wash you, make you clean, put away the evil of your doings from before my eyes, cease from doing evil. What is this that blood from the appearance of angels during the feast of Mary, is that good things cannot come from bad things. The scriptures And the law of God says, you should remain clean. Mary was a virgin. And that is why Jesus Christ came to her. She was conceived of the Holy Ghost or Holy Spirit. Neither could purity come from the purity. That is what we should learn. From Isaiah, it says, wash you, that is clean yourself. Remain clean. Listen to the word of God and adjust quickly to the laws of God.
Thank you, question number 5. And last question. What are the consequences of sexual immorality? Ephesians 5, Jude 1, 7, Revelation 2, 22, and Revelation 21, verse 8. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 5. For this you know, that no more hunger, nor unclean person, nor contentious man, who is an idolater, has any inheritance in the kingdom of Christ and of God. We are looking into the consequences for sexual immorality. Number one, according to the passage read, such that party sexual immorality will have inability to enter into the kingdom of God. Number two is unwanted pregnancy. Number three is contacting of sexual diseases, STD, HIV, and so on and so forth. Another one is that one will incur God's wrath and we have eternal damnation in fire. Thank you. Conclusion. The supernatural conception of our Lord Jesus Christ is a proof of his current and holiness from whom are the inheritance of Adam's sinful nation. He has to come through a woman who has had no sexual intercourse with any man to come to the world and fulfill the world of redemption. In group of thoughts, can we read together?
Christ is Yahweh, by the woman who was without the man's sin.
Memory verse, please, after me. Matthew chapter 1, verse 23.
Matthew chapter 1, verse 23.
Behold.
Behold.
Your father shall be with child.
Your father shall be with child.
And bear his son.
And bear his son.
And he shall call his name Emmanuel.
And he shall call his name Emmanuel.
Which is translated.
Which is translated.
God with us.
God with us.
Shall we pray? Father, then we thank you for the word you have sent to us this morning. Father, we pray, Lord, give us the grace to keep ourselves holy in this misery that we find ourselves. And I pray for all, give us the grace even to live with you in that kingdom. All these are our mercies. We ask for through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Seek the Lord while he be found. Call upon him by his name. The Lord is his good temple. Let all have decided before him. Dearly beloved, we are gathered on the throne of the Lord Almighty God to offer him our praise and thanksgiving, to hear his holy word, to bring to him the needs of the world, to ask his forgiveness of our sins, and to share his grace. And through his Son Jesus Christ, we will give ourselves to his service. Let us pray to confess our sins. See after me. Almighty God,
Almighty God,
our Heavenly Father,
our Heavenly Father,
we have sinned against you,
we have sinned against you,
and against our neighbors,
and against our neighbors,
in thoughts,
and words,
and in deeds,
two negligence,
two
weakness,
two our every faults, we are truly
sorry.
And the good of all our sins. For the sake of your Son Jesus Christ.
For the sake of your Son Jesus Christ.
Who died for us. Forgive us of our sins.
Forgive us of our sins.
And grant that we will serve you.
And grant that we may serve you.
In the newness of life.
In the newness of life.
Christ.
In the glory of your name.
In the glory of your name.
Amen.
Amen.
May the Holy God, for the Lord with grace, have mercy upon you.
Amen.
Father, I deliver you from all your sins.
Amen.
From all our sins, you brought goodness.
Amen.
And grant us grace and eternal life.
Amen.
To such Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord's prayer. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come,
your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, open our lips,
and our mouths shall proclaim thy praise.
O Lord, be sweet to save us.
O Lord, give grace to help us.
To the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning,
is now, and ever shall be. For without faith, amen.
Praise the Lord.
The Lord has given you praise.
The psalm appointed for this service is Psalm 45. So I commend reading from verse 1 to 11, and we are going to read it for 30. My heart is indicting in good matter. I speak of the things which have been worshipped with him. My tongue is the pen of the ready writer.
You are terrorist as the sons of men. Grace is full of all your lips. Therefore, God has blessed you forever.
God has sworn upon that time, O most mighty, with thy glory and thy majesty.
In our majesty, we cry out to the glorious people who are the cause of the Jesus Christ to defend the right. Let the right hand shall teach you to use
the right. Thy arrow are sharp in the heart of the king's enemies, whereby the people fall under thee.
Thou art the one who endures forever and ever. Your radiance of light is the center of righteousness.
Thou loving righteousness and hated wickedness. Hear, O God, thy God, and anointed thee with the oil of gladness above thy temples.
Your whole and our nations and
King's daughter were among thy honorable women. Upon thy right hand, this sang the queen in gold of copper. We shall read verse 11 together.
Service shall be found in St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 15, beginning at the 11th verse. And he said, a certain man had two sons, and the younger of them said to his father, Father, give me the portion of goods that fell to me. And he divided unto them his living. And not many days after, the younger son gathered all together and took his journey into a far country. And there wasted his substance with riotous living. And when he had spent all, there arose a mighty famine in that land, and he began to be in want. And he went and joined himself to a citizen of that country, and he sent him in And he will fill, have filled his belly with the husk that the swine eats, and no man gave unto him. And when he came to himself, he said, how many hired servants of my father's have bread enough and to spare, and I perish with hunger. I will arise and go to my father. I will say unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and before thee. I am no more worthy to be called thy son. Make me as one of the higher servants. And he arose and came to his father. But when he was yet a great way off, his father saw him and had compassion and ran and fell on his neck and kissed him. And the son said unto him, Father, I have sinned against heaven, and in thy sight I am no more worthy to be called thy son. But the father said to his servants, bring forth the best robe, and put it on him, and put the ring of his hand, and shoes on his feet, and bring hither the fattest calf, and kill it, and let us eat and be merry. For this my son was dead, and is alive again. He was lost, and is found, and he began to marry. This is the word of the Lord.
Be he for the son. If you remember, 391. Church of Nigeria Hymn, 601.
Oh, wants to give glory, honor, and adoration to God Almighty for the grace of today and for the privilege given to me by the Lord Bishop to lead this service and to preach at this time. I want to thank God for the grace of His blessings upon every one of us. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the grace given to us and for your love for the church. The church is marching on according to your promises. We thank you, Lord, for today. As we go into your word, speak to us in a simple language that we understand. In the right name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, take control. Holy Spirit, lead us. Holy Spirit, guide us. So that at the end, all of us will be blessed. For we pray in Jesus' mighty name. My dear Lord God, as you know that in our diocese, we have our team, which says, children are heirs in the kingdom. And we have been hearing under this team various topics on that team. We have revealed to us parent and children relationship to the kingdom. When we compare what happens to Jonathan, the king of children, at the age of 55, and when we see the relationship between the father and the boy, and that relationship happened when he was ruling over children. We can see this from 2 Chronicles chapter 27, verses 1 to 9. Likewise, we have looked into the children family platform, which is a forum to raise godly children. We have seen that, we have seen that one in Ephesians chapter 5, verses 1 to 12. We have treated parental responsibility. The first one is talking about biblical training. And the second one is talking about moral training. And the third one, we see that we should avoid negative confession. In the same thing, we are looking into parental responsibility 5, talking about knowing God's mind, in which we saw Rebecca and Isaac. Isaac prayed for Rebecca. And Rebecca conceived and inquired for God what is going to happen to those twins inside her. Dear people of God, the theme for today is finding your place in the kingdom. The text for this passage is Luke 15, verses 11 to 24. And we see that we are talking about the story of the prodigal son. Before I go further, I want us to look at some things here. When we talk about the kingdom, we are not talking about the earthly kingdom. We are talking about the kingdom of God, in which the Lord Jesus has promised us a place in that our kingdom. He said, I'm going to prepare a place for us. Prepare a place for you and prepare a place for me. We can see that one in John chapter 14, verses 1 and 2. Jesus has spoken to us about this kingdom and is mandatory for every one of us to walk for that kingdom. And I pray God will help us out in the mighty name of Jesus. Looking at the passage read and looking at the characters there, most especially the younger son who asks for his inheritance from the father. We can see the father did not argue with him, and the father gave him all. He went away and squandered all the inheritance given to him. As a period, he sat down, thinking about what has happened to him, thinking about the next line of action to take. My dear people of God, we can see that we have a second chance in the place of God, in the mind of God. This boy, after sitting down,
coming back to his senses, he knew that he needs to repent from his sin. Now we see what happens critically here, that the prodigal son sat down, come back to his senses, and then, let me take a bold stand. I'm going back home. I'm going back to my father. I just want you to take me back as a slave, not as a son again. Dear people of God, you too, you have a second chance. We also can come back to God Almighty for repentance. This boy repented of his sin and come back to God. My dear people of God, this is another chance for you and I. This is a period where you and I to think of the way we are living, the way we are thinking, so that God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. When you look at Matthew 20:22-23, we see the request of the mother of the two sons of the Zebedee requesting for a place in this earthly kingdom. But what Jesus is telling us is talking about the kingdom of God. The kingdom of God is not about request. It's a matter that you discipline yourself and you work for it. You pay a price for it. You cannot see that this mother is is requesting for a place which is not possible. But when we look at John Matthew 11:12, Jesus said, and from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven saw violence, and the violence taking it by force. Now, when we look at this passage and we compare it to what happened to the prodigal son, let's marry the two together and see that what to get to that place is a matter of working hard, is a matter of taking it by force, is a matter of disciplining yourself, is a matter of coming back, so that you repent of all your sins, because there is room for second time, of second chance from God Almighty. What can you do if you want to come back to the kingdom? Let's look from the point number one, self-discovery and repentance. We can see what happens to this son in Luke chapter 15, verses 14 to 19. This boy, as I've said earlier on, just sit down and thought of what to do again. He said, I need to come back to my senses and come back to repentance. You two, you are ready to proceed today. You have time now. Tomorrow will be too late. The minutes ahead of you may be too late. But if you repent now, I tell you, things will work well for you. This boy repented his sin and come back to Jesus. And it was forgiven. Another step you can take is stepping to forgiveness. It's a matter of one thing is to repent, and one thing is to move into that repentance. This boy said, I will arise and go back to my father. I've sinned against him and against my father. Now, Father, take me back as your slave, as your servant. But can I see that he was welcomed by the father? The father took him up and embraced him and forgave him absolutely. You too can be forgiven if you took the necessary step today. If you take the necessary step today and come back to Jesus, your sins will be forgiven. And I pray that as you are thinking about it, the Holy Spirit will give you a right in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Another step you can take is following the principles of discipleship. We need to follow the principle of discipleship. In other words, we need to take our cross. We need to take whatever we are passing through in Christendom. You take your cross. You forget about the past. Then you move towards the future. The future that we speak about the kingdom of God. The future that we welcome go back when the time comes. So let's now take that whole step so that the principle of discipleship will follow it later. And God will help us in the name of Jesus Christ. I want us to look at point number four. Obey the call of the Great Commission. The call of the Great Commission, we can see that one in Matthew 28, verses 19 to 20, where God is calling us to move out. Go ye to the world and preach the gospel. go you to the world and show the light to the Gentiles. Go you to the Lord, to the world, and let people know God, and let people hear about the news of God. And Lord, we have us in the name of Jesus Christ. My dear listeners, as I bring all this to, as I bring this family, as I bring this into conclusion, I want you to examine your ways. I want you to examine your life. I want you to see the type of life that you are living. I'm calling us to repentance. I'm inviting us to Jesus now. Jesus is awaiting you. Jesus is looking for you. Please and please, God needs you more than before. Your attention is to come back to Jesus. Your thinking is how to make heaven. Before we do that, I pray God will help you and God Almighty will stand by you as you are preparing your mind to come back to Jesus. Jesus says, I have the way. There is no any other way. The only way to salvation is our Lord Jesus. Now I'm calling you to repentance. I'm calling you to salvation. Jesus is the way. It's the light. It's the life. When coming to Him, you will be free. You will be free from sin. You will be free from the agony of life. Finally, there will be a day you will leave this sinful world. Thereby, you will give account of your stewardship. On that day, by the special grace of God, you will not regret all your actions in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you. God bless you. I want to once again pray for you. As you go out after this moment, God Almighty will give you a light. As you go out, you see the grace of God. The hands of God will be upon you, and the grace that you need to repent and come back to Jesus, God will give it to you in the name of Jesus. Once again, you are blessed in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Towo. Out the war, which is all in Baboa. Muga, Omo Baba, Omo Mari, Ela, Omo Waye, Muga, Jesu Christi, Omo Rengi, Moshu Suluwa, Eritia, Femi, Moloyu, Eritia, Vini, Maria, Mutia, Eritioji, Omo Pansu, Pinatu, Eritia, Kamadi, Lemu, Eritio, Kotia, Sisi, Oso, Kale, Rengu, Nijoketa, ti o ta ogogo ti awa le fe yo nitori Jesu Kristi Oluwa wa.
Amen.
Ọlọ́run ẹni tí ṣe olórísọ àlàáfíà tó lè fẹ́ ìrẹ́pọ̀ nígbà ẹni tí ṣe ìyà nípa ẹ̀kọ́ àti sísẹ ní bíṣọ́bù rẹ lálẹ́tọ́ dáàbò bò wá nípa àwọn ọmọ ọ̀dọ́ rẹ ní gbogbo ìbọ̀lù àwọn ọ̀tá wa ní àwọn ẹni tí gbẹ́kẹ̀ ní àwọn rẹ gidigidi má bẹ̀rù agbára ọ̀tá pọ̀tàlá nítorí agbára Jésù Kristi Olúwa wa. Àdúrà fún àkókò àjàkálẹ̀ àrùn Ọlọ́run Olódùmarè nínú ìbínú rẹ ìwọ ojú ọ̀rọ̀ àrùn sára àwọn ènìyàn tirẹ ní agbègbè nítorí ìṣọ̀tẹ̀ wọn sí Mọ́sí àti sí Aaroni àti pẹ̀lú ní ìgbà Dáfídì ọba tí ó sì fi àjàkálẹ̀ àrùn pa ẹgbàá márùn dín ní ogójì ènìyàn ṣùgbọ́n tí ó rántí àánú rẹ tí ó sì dá àwọn ìyókù sí ṣe ìyọnu sí àwa òtòṣì ẹlẹ́ṣẹ tí a ń fi ààrùn ńlá àti ikú bẹ̀wò nísinsìnyí pé bí o ti gba ìtìkù ní ìgbà náà tí ó sì pàṣẹ fún áńkẹ́lì apanirun láti dáwọ́ ìbánirin dúró bẹ́ẹ̀ ni kí ó sì wọ́ nísinsìnyí láti fa búburú yìí sẹ́yìn kúrò lára wa nítorí Jésù Kristi Olúwa wa. Almighty God, you are God of all nations and God of all flesh. We thank you, O God, for a moment like this. We appreciate you for everything you have been doing in our lives collectively and individually. Mostly, we thank you for the whole world. Thank you for Nigeria. Thank you for Ogun State. At the moment which COVID-19 is terrifying all the places, Lord Jesus, we submit to you the whole world at this time. Our knowledge, wisdom, understanding have failed us. Logical experiences have failed us. We have come back to you, O God, for the right solution. Lord, we release everything unto you. We need you, O God, more than before. Lord, take control in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes. If there is anyone under the influence of sickness, I declare right now be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. I speak to your brain. I speak the word of deliverance and healing to your kidneys and liver. Every part of body that was affected by any sickness, receive healing in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Kings. Lord Jesus, we pray for our children. Lord, be with them in the mighty name of Jesus. We pray for you, Lord, mighty God, watch over them in the mighty name of Jesus. We ask for wisdom and understanding for our leaders, Lord, release unto them in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord Jesus, at the end of our race here on earth, mercifully count us worthy in your kingdom. In Jesus' offering name we pray. Amen. Lord, we love you, Mary. Ẹni tí ó fún wa ní olóòfẹ́ nísinsìnyí láti wá fi ọkọ̀ ọmọ bẹ̀bẹ̀ lọ́dọ̀ rẹ. Ó tún ṣe ìlérí pé nígbà tí ẹni méjì tàbí mẹ́ta bá kọ́ra wọn lójú orúkọ ló fi béèrè wọn fún wọn. Olúwa mú ìfẹ́ náà àti ìbéèrè àwọn ọmọ rẹ tó ṣe nísinsìnyí. Ní ó ti lè gbé fún wa jùlọ. Máa fi mọ̀ títà rẹ fún wa ní ayé yìí àti ní ayé tí ń bọ̀. Iyè àyípẹ̀ gẹ́gẹ́ bí ẹbí kan mú kristi ẹjẹ́ ká tó mọ̀ṣàbí ọ̀rẹ́ ọ̀fẹ́ rẹ̀
ọ̀rẹ́ ọ̀fẹ́ jésù
kristi olúwa wa àti ìfẹ́ ìtì ọlọ́run àti ìgbàgbọ́ ti ẹ̀mí mímọ́ kí ó máa bá a gbé títí láyà
amen. As the presence of Francis, we want to take our tithes and collection Sunday offering. Likewise, any other offering that you give today. Those of us that are your various groups, we ask you to collect your time and Sunday offering and send it to your church account. Please do so, and God will bless you in Jesus' name.
Heavenly Lord, your name is wonderful, your name is marvelous, your name is beautiful. We worship you, Lord, for you are mighty. Together, O God, we are mighty.
Period of time, we sit before your presence. And therefore, we have come to you. If this spoken from us, we have that you will bless it.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
You will use it for the fullness of your glory here on earth in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
And we also pray that each and one of us, at this troubled time, you will replenish us. Lord, we will not fear you.
Yeah.
And so, bless us, we will also pray that you will give us the grace to go out for you.
Amen.
And so, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
We will pray your prayer.
Amen.
You are your friend. You are my
friend.
And here we are, my brother. I want to register my thanks to God Almighty for the success of this program today. I want to specially thank my Lord Bishop that gave me all grace to preach to the whole world at this time. I pray that God Almighty will continue to bless your ministry in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And that houses will continue to move forward and forward all the time in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We cannot prevail upon this church in Jesus' mighty name. As we bring this service to those, we want to sing from Church of the Nigeria hymn 463, 354.